started doing what he was doing with MKLeo. I was saying, it's like, this character is much harder to play than people anticipate.
I love Fire
and, yeah, I love Ike. They go with a bracket, and then they get bodied by Wolf. What do you mean I'm an Animorph? So, going into game one here, again, this is a money match. It's Mighty Kamina. Mighty Kamina. I want to say Kamina because I want to truly believe.
Kamina.
Yeah, I want to truly believe that that's definitely Gurren Lagann related. And obviously, we already know who this is.
Power.
Okay. Believe in the you that believes in me. I mean, believe in the me that believes in you. Damn it! All right, so.
You had one chance.
Damn it! It's okay. This is the drill that appears to happen. All right, I got some other ones. So, starting off here, actually, Mr. E behind, but this is a matchup where regardless of how much Mr. E takes in terms of damage, he can easily get a kill at very low percents because of how susceptible that recovery is.
Yeah. I also like the fact that, well, now he can do
like
that.
The fact that he's dead. The Belmonts have gone down. Again, that's a situation like when you're playing a character like that, you have to be able to recover and you have to be able to tech. Like, in particular, it's so bad when you're playing against Dolphin Slash or anybody who has a good hitbox to harass you off stage.
Yeah. But you saw that falling up there he did just to avoid the holy water. Oh my god. He's just whipping it.
Yo, when your mom rears like all the way back because she caught you sneaking in late. It's just a money match. We're being way too professional about this. Yo, you got body. Let's go.
Falling up.
I realize, this ain't no actual singles. This is all. This is a money match. All right, this is going to be a bad time going late.
I like that air dodge. I love that
air dodge. Air dodge was so intelligent. Like, I don't even need this stuff.
This goes into my carpool money.
I actually almost had a good call there, thinking Mr. E was going to put a hitbox down with the F smash. Like, you got to throw out a lot more projectile. There you go. There you go. Okay. Rack up that damage right there. That was really good from about 20
Do
to 63.
Your job. Falling back bears.
It's like you said, don't work too hard. Let it work for you. As a Belmont, sit back. Throw all the projectiles out there. Let them get mad. Let them get upset. Not, like, he decided to go for a dash attack there for damage. Maybe he wants to guarantee that he gets the kill. But forcing Mr. E off stage to go much further might have been a better call.
All right. Jump. Dare on shield being saved for the Belmonts. And Eric, what are you doing?
Yes.
What are you doing?
He's a huge fan of any type of goes for that. There you go. Get clapped. That's going to be an evening of the stocks.
You know, I actually believe Eric doesn't play this game.
Like, I mean, with the things.
Like, he just hard resets.
The things he says sometimes about the game that, like, this man's been a semi, like, you know, he's been playing this game for a long time.
He's been playing since Brawl.
He's got good W's.
Did
he
know?
It's a good way to get good W's when the Belmonts don't make it back.
Yeah. Did he know he did not know what power shielding was until Smash 4?
He said something else recently, too, that made me question it.
Oh, so.
Yeah, you know the beats. Give it to him.
I just finally learned what frame data was.
Yo, that's 100% what it was that I heard him, that I saw him say. It's like, bruh, how long have you been playing fighting games?
He didn't know how many frames were in a second.
I don't understand. Like, Smash is one of those games.
We were telling him numbers, and he said he nods his head like he understood. Mm-hmm. Eric's that kid in class, guys.
Yeah, he's like, yo, all of my hits are frame one. Like, Eric.
What?
Eric, no.
Life doesn't work like that.
only wish it did. Now you see a nice crowd pan there over on the left hand side. That's actually where some of that circuit matches is going on for the Collision Series circuit. Back in this though. Mr. E going in a little bit harder, like, you know, he did seal that out, but also there was two situations where he just didn't make it back. Like, the air dodge and then not grabbing with the fair, giving him free recoveries.
Yeah.
I just realized Devin put money match LMA. That's what we do to hold down the gap. We're actually way ahead of schedule on doubles.
Doubles kind of ended really early. I like the dash back, Eric. Let me take notes here in my pool.
Yeah, Mighty Kamina is going to get bodied. He's going to get absolutely bodied. There is no intellectual thing I was going to say that he could have done there whatsoever. He's dead. But actually, that was a really good mash out from Mr. E there to avoid getting hit.
Mash out, masher, we know.
hopefully he didn't blow his jump there early.
Yeah, he blew it.
It's so many people get stressed when a sword fighter's coming at you like that. You have to be very wary of your jump. Lucina can snipe that out so easy. Not sure what that was all about.
Yeah.
It's like, you know what, that fire looks good. Well, it's Eric, hot in here. What are you doing?
Eric's like a moth. He just like goes towards the flame.
See, the light just goes right to it. Good option coverage from him right there too. Mighty Kamina trying to find his way down. Finally throwing an up B off of shield pressure, but.
Yeah. But a little Shoryuken right there.
Yeah, just mini, do it, get back.
Mini dive kick, looking like Dr. Doom.
Mm-hmm. Foot dive.
Foot
I
dive.
Have actual nightmares from playing. I was talking to Cable a few minutes ago about the days of Marvel and Marvel how I got 3. Absolutely sauced by Justin Wong when I went to next level. It made me cry. Made me never want to touch it again. I still played it, but it was terrible.
That sounded like a good experience.
No, it was bad, man.
You just beat.
Oh my God, kind of like that. Like, I thought I had nothing I could do. That's what happened to Mighty Kamina. Mighty Kamina getting destroyed. And then the crowd having a good old time with it, too.
I hear he likes giving out money.
Yeah, you know.
Mighty Kamina. He loses side bets to me. He loses money matches to Mr. E.
Yeah. Yeah, I saw him saying that to you before. I was like, yo, I am the side bet king here. I was like, yo, you don't know Reggie like that, man. But then again, I did see, I saw a couple sad faces on you recently at Collision, though. Are you going to Pound?
No, I'm no longer going to Pound.
Why are none of y'all going to Pound when I can finally go to Pound?
I'm not going to Pound.
Y'all are killing me,
so
man.
So I was signed up for Pound.
Wait, what'd you say? You don't have a car? Oh, yeah, life is hard. Yeah, I feel you on that.
So I was signed up for Pound. I had a ride there because I'm driving. And then my job says, yo, you got to work for that Friday. And I'm like, gay?
Gay? No habla. All right, so, we getting some water. Let's go. All right, so back on this, though, the thirst for victory is on the side of Mighty Kamina because he's actually putting on some percent lead here. But he's getting called out on his landings right there. And again, throwing out quite a few air dodges. That's a swift way to get damage rack up quick, especially with the way Mr. E seeks out your landings.
Okay, parry. Looking like training mode. You got nothing off it, but. Eric ran right back into the fire.
I tell you, man, like, I don't know why, but apparently he's feeling cold. He's trying to warm it up. Like, he did just get here. It's like, that's not how you warm it up.
It's like, yo, my hands are cold. Yo.
Actually, he's trying to make some money back because he definitely missed out on that potential circuit money because he was not here. And that's some big money they had for that, too. It's a couple $1,000s on that circuit on the line.
Yeah.
So he's going to be money matching all day to make that back. Good defense from Mighty Kamina there, actually. Not like trying to be too aggressive again after that parry, seeing a potential opening.
Yo, I like that parry up smash though. He learned that from me.
You definitely taught him everything he knows. You were definitely.
It's not much, but.
I mean, you are literally everywhere.
Keep talking. Keep talking about me.
Now we're gonna talk about that dancing blade that moves so much worse than.
That, but I feel like it's so much better.
Yeah. Don't take anything we're doing seriously right now, by the way. It is a money match.
I'm the most serious person.
There's going to be so many people trying to pull me up later for like, oh, what do you mean it's not good? Like, I'm joking, man. I'm sorry. I'm just kidding.
It's the best move in the game.
No, it is definitely
worse. It's like frame 3. Woo! Oh, my God. He clipped him.
Literally clipped him with the axe. You know, it was the first time he pulled out the counter, too. Like, he had it thrown out the entire time anticipating something aggressive. And then you just have to stare at your death coming at you from the axe. Like, man, you know what? I really blew it.
I messed up.
And again, see, Mr. E adjusted to it that time.
Yeah.
He did the dare, tried to fade away the exact same way because it worked last time. And you see right there, he's already conditioned him to go for the air dodge because he knows he's going to be aggressive. Like, what are you going to do? You're going to SD. That's what you're going to do.
Oh, I thought that was his last dog.
Nah.
He has one more.
Nah, no, we still got more. He still got potential, but let's be real. He's bad, man.
Yo, Eric caught the water.
Where are you going?
I'm scared.
I will laugh when he goes back to watch it later for actual notes.
So did you know if the opponent catches the water, he can't throw another water?
That I did not know. I usually see people just throw it immediately back. And the Belmonts kind of fell off for the most part in terms of like upper play. Like not too many people are playing that much because when you have an inexploitable recovery, really hard to deal with when you have so many characters like Lucina and Peach floating through the upper portion of the meta. And that's an anti-air on his jump. He's dead. That's going to be some swift money making. Money in the bank for him. Hug's throwing out. And you know what? Jokes aside, I'm always a fan of watching people do money matches and stuff like that against people who are better than them because it's a good way to get somebody to be serious and to actually get some viable practice because if you get bopped in bracket, maybe you don't run into somebody you've been trying to practice against in bracket, or maybe you want to play against a top player who just doesn't have the time for you right now, but you throw some money on the line, all of a sudden, all right, you know what? Yeah, I got a few minutes. I want to make some McDonald's money real quick.